Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can count length of string with the help of pointer. Before start, if you go to description of this video, you will find links of various playlists related to C language. So you can follow them to watch previous videos. Now, first I am going to declare a string. Then I will tell you how we can process this with the help of pointer. So let's say in the beginning, I have character array or string. Its size is 10, and here I am assigning India into it. So you can assign string within double quotes directly to a character array. So after this, 10 blocks will be allocated. These are the indexes. This is the name of this character array, and it will be having these values assigned. After assigning India, it will be having null at the end, right? So these are indexes. In middle, we have all the values, and at top, I am writing addresses. So all these are addresses. And remember that I have assumed these addresses, because whenever you declare any variable in programming and you run that program on laptop, so your system automatically assigns a particular address, or you can say the available address, to that variable. So here we declared a variable named as str, that is known as string as well. So this string is having 10 locations. So all these 10 locations will be having 10 different addresses, right? Because in C programming, character is having 1 byte of memory. Character variable allocates 1 byte of memory, or you can say it occupies 1 byte of memory. So here size is 10. So total 10 blocks are available. So they are having 10 different addresses, one for each byte. If we have integer array, then each block will be having 2 bytes or 2 addresses. And if we have float, then each block will be having 4 bytes or 4 addresses, right? So this way it works. So now I'm going to use this character array or string with the help of pointer. So here I'm going to declare a pointer of type character. So remember that if you want to process character array or string, then pointer must be of type character, because whenever we are going to one location to another, so we need to know how much bytes we need to skip or jump. So if pointer is of type character, then it will always jump 1 byte. If it is of integer type, so it will jump 2 bytes. If it is of float type, then it will jump 4 bytes, right? So according to the variable, you need to declare pointer of that type only. Now we need to count the length. So I am declaring one integer variable that will be initialized with C equals to 0. Now through this pointer, I am going to access all the locations of this character array. So I am writing P equals to str. So here you need to remember that whenever we use name of any array, so it automatically provides base address of that location. So this is P, and it will be having 101. So this 101 is also known as base address. And don't remember like 101. So whatever will be the address, beginning address, will be known as base address. So right now it is 101. So 101 is base address. If it is 201, so then 201 will be the base address, right? So whatever will be the beginning address, that will become base address. And if you use name of any array, whether it is of type character, integer, float, they automatically provides beginning address to any pointer if you are using pointer. So this pointer is having 101 as the beginning or base address. Now I can apply while loop having this asterisk p not equals to null. So I am going to explain this. First, let me write all the statements. So C++ for counting purpose, P++ so that pointer can move to next location, so that we can identify that location's value. And after completion of this loop, I can write length equals to %d and c. Now I am going to explain this loop so that you can understand how length will be identified with the help of pointer. So here you can see in this loop, str is not used anywhere. In this loop, str is not used anywhere. In place of str, I am using the pointer, which will provide me all the available values so that I can count how many characters are there. So first, understand the meaning of this asterisk. Its mean is value at address. Asterisk means value at address. So right now P is having 101. So we can write it like this, asterisk 101. So this asterisk P will convert into asterisk 101. And meaning of asterisk is value at address. So value at 101 is I. So now check I not equals to null. So it is true. So I hope you understood how through this pointer I am able to access the value. So pointer is having address of that location. So instead of accessing this location through its name, I am accessing its location through its address. So I is not equals to null. So C will be incremented. So initially C is 0, so now it will be 1. Then P will be incremented. So I already explained you, if we increase any pointer, so its address will be incremented as per its data type. So P pointer is of character type. So P pointer address that is available inside that pointer will be increased by 1. So it will be having 102. If you have pointer of integer type, so integer pointer always increases the address which is stored inside that pointer by 2 and float by 4. So now P is having 102 as address. So again dereference it. So this time you can dereference it like this, asterisk 102. So again value at address 102. It is n not equals to null. So C will be incremented. Again P will be incremented to 103. So asterisk 103 value is d, d is not equals to null. So c will be incremented to 3. Again p will be incremented. So it is 104. Check value at 104. It is I not equals to null, true. C will be 4. P will be incremented to 105. Check asterisk 105. So 105 value is a, which is again not equals to null. So c will be incremented to 5. And P will be incremented to 106 and D reference 106. So value at 106 is null. So this time loop will be false. And after termination of loop, this printf will be displaying length equals to %d C. So value of C is 5. So 5 will be printed here. And you can count total number of characters are 5. So we are not counting null. We are counting the characters which are available before null value. So this way you saw how I iterate this loop with the help of pointer only without using the variable name. So whenever you want to access any array, whether it is character type, integer type or float type, using its address, so you can use pointer, assign base address or beginning address of that array into that pointer, increase that pointer one by one, and through asterisk you can access a particular value and you can process whatever you want to perform. So I hope you understood how I explained you this process. So you understood how we can process string using pointer. And in string we have null, so you need to increase the pointer till null comes. If you are on the null position, you can terminate the loop. And you can print or you can show the outcome to the user. So I hope you understood whatever I explained related to string and pointer in this video. If you want to watch more videos, open my channel and then you will find lots of video. Or you can go to description of this video where you will find various playlists related to C language. So you can watch them too. So thank you for watching this video.